Hello and welcome to the first video in our course on cell biology and genetics. In this video, we're going to talk about chromosomes. So what are you going to learn in this video? We're going to discuss what chromosomes actually are, how many there are in the human body, we're going to look at their structure, and we're going to talk about the different types of chromosomes. After watching this video, you will also understand the terms gene, genome, junk DNA, and karyotype. So these are our goals, and now let's get down to business. Chromosomes are structures that contain molecules of DNA and proteins that have various functions. They can modify the DNA, they are involved in DNA replication, DNA repair, gene expression, and much more. We are definitely going to discuss them later in our course. Okay, so that's what chromosomes are. Next question is, where are they? As you probably know, chromosomes are located in the nucleus of the cell, so in the innermost part of the cell. Chromosomes carry genes, and genes are segments of DNA that code for proteins or RNA molecules. So in other words, genes are parts of DNA of various sizes that contain code necessary for the synthesis of a protein or an RNA molecule. What's interesting is that there are also parts of DNA that don't code for any protein or RNA molecule, and we call these segments junk DNA. But be careful, it may be called junk DNA, but this DNA definitely has a very important role, although we're not yet exactly sure which. Okay, so again, genes code for proteins, junk DNA doesn't code for anything. When you want to refer to both the coding DNA, so genes, and the non-coding DNA, you can use the term genome, which refers to all the genetic material there is in the organism. Okay? So genes, junk DNA, together genome. Now moving on to our next question. How many chromosomes are there in humans? Let's take a look. We have 24 types of chromosomes. There are 22 chromosomes that are numbered from 1 to 22, and these we call autosomes. The remaining two types of chromosomes are sex chromosomes, Y and X. As you know, women have two X chromosomes, and men have one X and one Y chromosome. All these chromosomes are of different sizes, but we're also going to talk about this later. Now, human cells contain two copies of each chromosome, so two copies of chromosome 1, two copies of chromosome 2, etc., together making 23 copies of total, or 46 chromosomes. This is true for almost every cell in the body, except for germ cells, for example, which only contain one copy of each chromosome. A full set of these 46 chromosomes is called a karyotype. And here you can see one, a bit simplified, but you see the two copies of each chromosome, and you can also see that we have two copies of sex chromosome X. So we're looking at a woman's karyotype. Okay, now let's look at one individual chromosome and its structure. A chromosome has two arms, a P arm and a Q arm. Between them is a structure called centromere that is very important during mitosis, which we're also going to talk about in this course. Now, at each end of a chromosome is a structure called telomere, which protects the ends of the chromosome and is responsible for their proper replication. Telomeres are very interesting structures, and we are also going to spend some time talking about them later. Finally, we have a chromatid, which is a molecule of DNA. Here we have two chromatids, two molecules of DNA. That's because in this picture, you can see a chromosome after replication, so a chromosome that has two molecules of DNA, so two chromatids. So instead of saying that the chromosomes have two molecules of DNA, we can simply say that they have two chromatids. And a chromosome that is not replicated is logically going to have only one chromatid. Okay? Finally, not all chromosomes were created equal, and we distinguish different types of chromosomes. We have a metacentric chromosome whose P and Q arm are almost identically long. Then we have a submetacentric chromosome whose P arm is shorter than its Q arm. Acrocentric chromosome has a very short P arm, and a telocentric chromosome has only Q arms. Later in this course, we're going to look at different chromosomes and classify them, saying whether they're metacentric, submetacentric, acrocentric, or telocentric. Okay, so these are all the things we need to know for now to be able to properly describe chromosomes and understand what they actually are. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful and you would like to watch more videos about cell biology or medicine in general, please subscribe. Thank you again, and don't forget that medicine can be easy.